Hi everybody, welcome back to another STEM video. STEM is science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And today I'm going to show you how to make a really awesome toy called a Whirligig. So Whirligigs are an ancient toy that have been played with by children all over the world for a very long time. We don't know who invented the first one, but they have found Whirligigs made of bone and clay in North America. And evidence of the toy is present in China as far back as 400 BC, and in Egypt as far back as 100 BC. These toys are present in early European literature and in medieval sites in London. So obviously this is a toy that has been played with by a lot of different kids all over the world for a very long time. And today I'm going to show you how to make one. You will need some cardboard, nylon or cotton string, a glue stick. You're going to need something to mark with. I have a pencil. There are lots of awesome templates online. But if you don't use one of these, you're going to want some markers or crayons to color with. If you don't use a template, you're going to need something to color with. It's nice to have a straight edge, something to measure with. You're going to need some scissors, and you're going to need something to poke a hole with. So I would use a safety pin or a push pin or a paper clip. Let's get started. All right, everybody, the first thing we need to do is cut out a circle. To make a perfect circle with cardboard, you're gonna want your cardboard, your pencil, and of course something to trace. So I have this cup here. Like that, and then you have a circle that is the right size. You want your cardboard circle to be a little bit big, so you want it to be between 3 and 4 inches, and of course you can see this one is right at 4 inches, so that is the perfect size for our experiment today. You will then need to cut out your cardboard. Now that we have our circle cut out, we need to find the center of our Whirligig. So grab a piece of paper and to trace your circle one more time. And now let's cut it out. All right, now that we have our scrap paper template, we can put it on top of our template, our original one, and you can see that it fits just perfectly. So what you're going to do next is fold your circle in half like this. I would call this a taco fold because it looks just like a taco. Then you're gonna fold it again. All right, and then you're going to unfold it, and that point in the middle is your circle, all right? So you can take your circle template and your cardboard circle, and you're going to line up your edges of your circle. Perfect. And then you're going to take your safety pin and you're going to push down in the middle just to mark it, not all the way through, but just to mark it just like that. All right. And that is how to find the center of your circle. Now, the reason that's important is because we need to put a couple of holes in our template to run our string through. All right. So if we know where the center is, we know we can put two equal holes on the side of it. So that's what we're going to do next. What I would recommend is doing 1 centimeter on each side. So let's line this up and punch one little hole on 1 centimeter on one side, 1 centimeter long, and then turn it over and using the middle, punch one more hole, 1 centimeter long all the way through, just like that. All right, so you don't run your string through the middle hole, you run it through the two sides, side holes, but now we know where they are and we have holes for our string to run through. Our next step is decorating, which I think is the best step. So if you have a regular cardboard cutout like this, it's gonna be kind of hard to color on the top of it because it is dark brown. So what you might want to do is print out some templates. So I have these here, but if you want to design your own, that's also great. You can use a blank piece of paper and trace your cardboard again. And then take your glue stick and glue that to the side. But what we're gonna do is use 2 of our templates here. So let's cut those out next. Now that we have our templates cut out, it is time to glue them onto our cardboard circle. So for that, you need your glue stick.
I think glue stick works the best, but if you just have regular glue at home, that's okay. You can use regular glue as well. Now you want to make sure and get all the way to the edge of your paper template because when your Whirligig starts to spin, you don't want it to fly off. So make sure you get glue right up to the edge, just like that. And then you're going to glue it onto your circle. And what's nice about these templates, some of them have holes already, so you don't have to go through the measuring part, but if you have a template that doesn't have the two guiding holes, you will need to do the measuring step, which is what I showed you before. But now we are ready to add our string. Let's do that next. So you are going to need about 3 foot of string. So let's get our handy measuring tool here. About three feet of string. It doesn't have to be exact, and if you have really long arms, you might want a little bit more, but 3 feet is about what you need. All right, so now we need to go back to our little template here, and I'm gonna use the guide holes from before. Perfect, just like that. And now we need to run our string through. Just like that. Now this part's a little tricky, but you want to make sure that your string is going through both sides. So you're going to take the same end and push it through the other hole. Okay, so you're making a big circle with your string, but we will tie it on the other side so it doesn't fall out. All right, be careful not pull your string out through both ends. You want to make sure that you are just pulling the right string, the correct string, like this. All right, that's perfect. Now you need to tie both ends. And the best way I found to do it is to just take your two ends together and tie a nice little knot like that, all right? And then to make sure you did it right, you should have string going through both sides in one big circle. Now, I'm going to show you how to get it started. So you're going to want to hold the two ends in both of your hands like this. I like to use two fingers because I feel like I have more control with two. So you want to hold them like this and make sure that your Whirligig is in the middle and not all the way on one side. You want it to be in the middle. All right, now the best way to do it is to just start spinning it like this. So as you can see, I'm holding on to both ends of the string and I am letting the Whirligig's weight spin it, all right? Then you're going to pull back. Now sometimes it likes to flip sideways, but eventually you should get it started like this. And you can see it'll stand up. Now what I'm doing with my hands is just very gently pulling back and forth. And there it goes. And that's where it gets its name, that whirly sound, all right? So if you've made a Whirligig with a template, you can see how it kind of does different colors and things like that. And if you've made your own design, you can see how that turns out. So what I'm doing is just letting it pull and come back together. So the string is actually kind of pulling my hands, which is why I like to use the two fingers so I have more control over it. And that's how to make your Whirligig go.